السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. شبہات کا ازالہ پیج کو سبسکرائب کریں اور بیل آئیکن دبائیں سب سے پہلے ویڈیو دیکھنے کے.
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. وائی از مولانا سعد صاحب امیر؟ انگلش ٹرانسلیشن آف مولانا محبوب's قسط 121. نوٹ: بیسٹ اٹمپٹ ہیز بین میڈ ٹو میک دا ٹرانسلیشن ایز کلوز ایز پاسبل ٹو دا اردو ورژن. میجر ٹاپکس کورڈ: اے پروف آف دا نیڈ فار اے سنگل پرماننٹ امیر، بی پرپز آف شورا، سی ہاؤ مولانا سعد صاحب بیکم امیر، ڈی بریف بایوگرافیز آف مولانا اظہار الحسن، مولانا زبیر الحسن اینڈ مولانا سعد، ای پریڈیسیسرز اوور لوکنگ انڈیویژلس آف دا کرنٹ ورلڈ شورا گروپ، ایف ایٹ ایڈوائسز ٹو ورکرز بائی مولانا محبوب صاحب، دا ورک آف دعوت اینڈ اٹس میتھڈ. نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم فورٹولڈ ٹو دا افیکٹ دیٹ آفٹر ہم دیر وڈ بی دا رین آف دا پائس خلیفاز، آفٹر دیٹ دیر ول بی دا رین آف دا جسٹ کنگ، دیر آفٹر اتھارٹیٹیو جابر کنگز. اٹ از کمپلسری ٹو لسن ٹو اینڈ اوبے دیم ود پیشنس اینڈ فرمنس سو لانگ ایز دے ڈونٹ انسٹرکٹ یو اگینسٹ شریا، ڈونٹ کاز ڈویژن اینڈ دین دین ول اسپریڈ سلولی اینڈ خلافت ول بی اسٹیبلشڈ. کمنس: دس حدیث از ان ابو داؤد اینڈ ان ویریس ادر صحیح بکس وتھ سملر ورڈنگس. انٹل قیامت دس حدیث از دا میتھڈ آف دعوت. In this hadith, mention is made of imarat, kingship, etc. Nowhere is the mention of shura, because to listen to and obey can be attributed only to one person. The proof of this can be extracted from this hadith. Is it possible to obey a 20, 50, 100 person shura? To obey and follow Allah's order assiduously is easy because He is one. This is why in Quran it's mentioned that if there was another ilah with Allah, the necessary consequence of this would be corruption. In the same we obey Allah, we obey the Amir. In various ahadith books, it comes to the effect that whoever obeys my Amir obeys me, and whoever obeys me obeys Allah. This hadith is not accorded the acceptance that it should by the common people. For many, this will be the first time they have come across this hadith. It contains the method and convention of Da'wat. In the aforesaid hadith, it's clear-cut listen and obey. In contrast, the hadith that Islam is based on five things is known to everyone as it is mentioned in jalsas, from the members, etc. Since this hadith is famous amongst the general public, the understanding of deen is limited to act of worship. In contrast, the hadith that Islam is based on five things is known to everyone as it is mentioned in jalsas, from the members, etc. Since this hadith is famous amongst the general public, the understanding of deen is limited to acts of worship. Yet the hadith provides information only. There is no express command or forbidding in this hadith. However, in the first mentioned hadith, there is clear-cut order that for ijtimaiyat, unity of the ummat, obey the king, ruler, amir, etc. Whatever level of deen is in the common people, that will be the level of deeni knowledge amongst them. The fact that deen is only on the level of worship amongst the common people, that's why they are only aware of the latter hadith above, and not the former pertaining to obedience of the Amir. Shura is to designate an Amir, not to act as a substitute. Whoever says that Mashwara has a faisal and he is like the Amir is wrong, because the faisal's decision making is restricted to the Mashwara. Once the Mashwara is finished, the faisal's Imarat is also finished. In the aforementioned hadith, the command is for a continuing Amir, such an Amir that all 24 hours he is in worry and concern for the umurs. Whoever says that in the Markaz there should be a weekly or monthly faisal is an ignoramus. He is not aware even from a distance of the command of Sharia or the method of Dawat or Sirat. He is simply desirous of rank. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's shura. Before his passing, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appointed a shura of 10 ashra mubashara and informed them that between yourself select an Amir. In Markaz Nizamuddin, the Imarat of Maulana Saad sahab is established. This is because Maulana Inamul Hasan informed Maulana Saad before he passed away that he should become the Amir. Maulana Saad sahab requested Maulana Inamul Hasan to contemplate over it. He advised that if I am made Amir, then Maulana Zubair's halqa, people will be upset, and if he is Amir, then the people who are desirous of me will be upset. Maulana Inamul Hasan replied that in that case Maulana Izharul Hasan will oversee the both of you, and the three of you together will be responsible for the work of Dawat in the Markaz. Maulana Saeed Ahmed Khan Sahab, Miyaji Mehrab Sahab and Naimullah Khan Sahab as Faisal determined that they should adopt the wishes of Maulana Inamul Hasan, and therefore appointed the three aforementioned individual as responsible for running the affairs of the Markaz. It is important for the readership to understand the caliber of these three people so that the heart can be at peace. A. Maulana Izharul Hasan was aged. Despite his weakness, he was responsible for Madrasa Kashiful Ulum, which is part of the Markaz. He was also responsible for the administrative arrangements in the Markaz and on a daily basis he undertook the nightly reading of Hayatul Sahaba in the Markaz. For a long period he attended to these duties and spent the later part of his life doing this. B. Maulana Zubairul Hasan Sahab was heavy bodied and therefore not a physical active. He was constantly engaged in zikr and dua. In 1980 when he went for Hajj, Hazrat Sheikh Zakariya Rahmatullah Alayh kept him behind for a considerable time and favored him with khilafat. He then returned to Markaz, at which time I was present. I noticed a change in his demeanor. For hours he would be engaged in dua and as a result he suffered weight increase. C. Maulana Saad was active. From the beginning, Hazrat Ji would take Maulana Saad on journeys. The blessing of this was that from an early age, Maulana Saad was familiar with the matters of Dawat. Predominantly, it was Maulana Saad who did all the work pertaining to an Amir. Until recently, 2014, the likes of Maulana Ahmad Lad Sahab and Farooq Bhai Bangalore never tried of praising Maulana Saad Sahab. All Arabs attested to the vibrancy of Maulana Saad Sahab's bayan and say that when he speaks, they are reminded of Maulana Yusuf Sahab Rahmatullahi Alayhi. Not only India but the whole world like Maulana because of his talk and they are happy with his decision making. During the life of Maulana Zubair and Maulana Izharul Hasan, both were happy with the decisions and the khidmat of Maulana Saad Sahab. Maulana Saad Sahab has continued in the same manner and thousands of old workers all over the world and approximately 150 Indian old workers who give time to the Markaz throughout Mashwara accept and are happy that Maulana Saad Sahab is Amir, with the exception of four people. First, Maulana Ahmad Lad, second, Farooq Bhai Bangalore, third, Professor Khalid Siddiqui, fourth, Professor Sanaullah. These four raised the issue of making a shura and to give strength to their movement. They joined with them Maulana Ibrahim Deola and Maulana Yaqub. The latter returned to Markaz after a short while and is now still residing there. The right to make a shura is the right of two people, Haji Abdul Wahab Sahab and Maulana Saad Sahab. The former, due to old age and illness, is like an innocent child, dependent on others' mercy and is excused in the term of Sharia. Maulana Saad Sahab has made a shura in Nizamuddin which conveys on a daily basis on matters pertaining to the work. Aside from these two, nobody has the right to establish a Markaz or World Shura. When Hazrat Ji Maulana Inamul Hasan established a 10-person Shura, he didn't include Maulana Ibrahim Sahab, Maulana Ahmad Lad Sahab or Farooq Bhai Bangalore. This was all from Allah. Had any of these rebellious ones been put in the Shura, they would have caused Qiyamah to come. Hazrat Ji and Miyaji Mehrab Sahab knew that the troublemakers were not worthy of such a lofty position. Fear the insight of a believer as he sees with the Noor of Allah. The proof of this is that the reality of these individuals was made evident to Hazrat Ji and Miyaji Mehrab Sahab. It's not possible that Hazrat Ji willfully ignored Maulana Ibrahim Deola or Maulana Ahmad Lad Sahab. Our elders did regular istikhara before making major decisions. Miyaji Mehrab Sahab, who was the Faisal, also did not mention either of their names, and not did Maulana Saeed Ahmad Khan Sahab. The comical aspect is that from this rebellious group, not one of their names was selected by Hazrat Ji in his list of 10 names. Despite this, the rebellious group's endeavors are that Nizamuddin is closed. The effect of Dawat there is finished. Imarat is removed and the almost 100 year of unity of the Markaz is destroyed. Since this rebellious group have no affiliation with the A'mals taking place within the four walls of the Markaz, and since they are not receiving or getting anything, the example is that of the saying in Urdu, "In stranger's wedding, Abdullah is lonely." This group is neither in the Markaz Shura nor are they amongst the trustees of the madrasa setup. It is first for those that consider themselves attached to Dawat and Tabligh to accept the following matters. First, Markaz Nizamuddin is our Markaz and the work will have to complete in accordance with the methodology of Nizamuddin. Second, Maulana Saad Sahab, the Amir of the world's Tablighis. Third, the orders and wishes of Maulana Saad Sahab will be followed solely. Fourth, the existing Shura in the Markaz is the real Shura. Fifth, all the world's marakis are subservient to Markaz Nizamuddin and are duty-bound to obey the pattern adopted by Maulana Saad Sahab. Alongside, Fazail-e-Amal Talim Muntakhab Adis should also be read. Sixth, regional interests should not take precedence over central attachment of the Markaz. This is what constitutes accepting the Markaziyat of Markaz. To adopt some A'mals and leave out others prescribed by the Markaz is to reject the Markaz and rebel against the Amir. 7. The whole world should read Muntakhab Hadith and with a clean heart and mind. All our issues pertaining to the effort should be presented to Hazrat Ji Maulana Saad Sahab and whatever is decided in Nizamuddin must be acted upon at a local level. 8. Obedience of the Amir is loyalty in worship, because Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to the effect that Whoever obeys my Amir obeys me, and whoever obeys me obeys Allah. To reject the Imarat of Maulana Saad Sahab is fitna, oppression and deviation. Imarat has been established. To deny is to deceive oneself. Beside a few, the whole world accepts the Imarat of Maulana Saad Sahab. Attempts have been made to make this rebellious group understand, but they rejected. For this reason, this group should be boycotted, so that the Ummah is saved from their impure intentions. Quran's ayat nearest translation. The house of the hereafter is only for those who do not seek position in this world, nor do they cause fasad in order to obtain leadership or position. The end result for the muttaqin is best. Surah Qasas. The soul of any amal is sincerity. Without sincerity, the amal is like that of a lifeless corpse. Does a lifeless corpse have any value? Maulana Mehmood.